guys, it's Angela from Panda Kisses, and I'm going to go ahead and do the tutorial on Parker on the Porch's taco zipper bag. This has been requested, so I'm going to go ahead and do it. So I'm going to do the 5x7 size. So I have my 5x7 hoop on my machine, and this is just tearaway. It's one sheet of tearaway. And let's get started. So we're going to do the first step, and the first step is to go ahead and stitch that placement step directly onto your stabilizer. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. I'll come back and show you.
Okay, guys, this is what that placement looks like. The next step is to place the zipper. Now, you're always going to place the zipper between these two placement lines. This middle line is where the teeth of the zipper should be lined up, and then you'll have a perfect alignment of a zipper. So I'm going to use a 9-inch zipper. This is a 9-inch zipper. And if you want to see where I buy my zippers, go look at the C below after the video, and I'll have links. So you basically line it up like that. If you want to unzip your zipper from this direction, from here to here, this is how you would have it. You'd leave it just like this. If you want the zipper to go the other direction, just flip the zipper and place it this way, and then it will unzip the other direction. I always do it the other direction, but I just want to show you. You have that choice. So you pick whichever, and then just go ahead and tape either side right here. Make sure it's lined up right. I'm just kind of placing it. I'll line it up right. Or you can hold it. I always hold it, but that's me. And then go ahead and stitch the next step. It's going to go ahead and put a line here and a line here, just tacking your zipper down. That's all it's doing. So I'm going to go ahead and run that, and I'll come back and show you.
Okay, guys, this is what it looks like. The zipper is tacked down. You can see that it stitched on both sides, so it's tacked down to the design. Now we're gonna go ahead and measure our fabric now, and I'm just gonna show you. I do not give measurements because then you have people complaining because I waste fabric. I don't like measure really close, and other people do. So it's not a good idea to give exact measurements. And if designers give exact measurements, I still measure myself because I don't want to end up being mad or whatever. So here's the way you measure. On what we need to do next is measure, because we're going to be putting the front of our bag down. So I take a ruler, I measure from my zipper teeth down to the farthest point. So I put my zero right there and I measure down. You can see that it's like right at 3. There will be people that do exactly 3 and they're going to be right here next to the edge. I'm not that person. I don't want to have to be so precise that I ruin my design if I mess up. So I measure, I look here and I see that it's like right about 3. I give myself some extra room. So I cut a little further than 3. Now the other way, the other thing you do is you measure from the top of here to the teeth right here. So I'm going to go ahead and measure that. And you can see, like, if you do it exact, it's like a little more than 1.5. But I just go ahead, I'll probably measure 2 right here, because you see 2's right here. So I'll have a little bit up here, a little down here, and I'll have room for it. So I'll probably cut mine that way. The other thing I do is I cut on a cutter. And the reason I do that is because you want a straight edge right here. And I'm using vinyl, but you still want a straight edge because it's going to go up along this. So I always use my cutter to make sure my vinyl's getting cut straight. So I'm going to go ahead and use this vinyl. I buy all my vinyl from My Punk Broidery. I have links in the C below if you want to see. Marine vinyl. This is a glitter marine vinyl. You can see that it's fairly thick. If you're doing bags, be prepared when you're turning your bag, it's harder to turn because this is thicker. So you got to be willing to do that turn. If you're using this thick vinyl. But this is what I'm using. It's marine yellow glitter vinyl from My Punk Broidery. I wanted to show you the difference. This is canvas. Canvas is thinner. This is also glitter, but canvas is a lot thinner. It's going to be a lot easier to turn. But I just wanted to show you the difference in size. Let's see if I can get there. The thickness is a lot different, but they're both really pretty and they're both really glittery. So again, canvas, thinner. Marine glitter, thicker. I just wanted to show you the difference. But anyways, I went ahead and cut, and you can see that I cut my piece for up here. I cut my piece for down here. This is the front of the bag. Then you need one more piece that is the back of your bag, and it goes the whole distance. So you're going to want to measure from the top all the way to the bottom. And I already did that, so I have this big piece right here that will go across the whole back. So I have my vinyl set and cut. I showed you how to cut it. We're going to go back to the machine. I'm going to show you how to place it.
Okay, here we are. We're back on the machine, and we are going to place this bottom piece first. This is the front of your bag, the bottom half. So I'm going to go ahead and do that right now, and I place my fabric all the way up to my zipper line. You can see, let me pull this out, you can place it anywhere above, like a little bit above this line. This is where it's going to stitch, so you got to make sure your fabric's above that stitch line, because that's what's going to tack it down to the bag. So you got to make sure it's above that. But you can do it just barely above, so it shows more of the color of your zipper, or you can place it right up to your zipper teeth. I tend to place mine closer to my zipper teeth. It's just what I do, but you are welcome to do either. So I'm going to go ahead and place my fabric. Just make sure you're around all those placement lines and go ahead and stitch step three. I'll come back and show you what that looks like. Okay, there you go. You can see that it's stitched all the way around my vinyl. So we have our bottom half on. So now the next step is to stitch up here. So I'm going to put my vinyl up here, make sure it's around all my placement lines, and place it next to my zipper how I want it. And then I'm going to go ahead and stitch step four, and I'll come back and show you what that looks like.
Okay guys, here's what it looks like. We have the top of our bag and the bottom of our bag for the front all tacked down. The next step's gonna be to do details on the front of your bag. So we're gonna be making the taco face and the lettuce and all the condiments that go on a taco. I'm going to show you what I do on this. You absolutely do not have to do these added steps, but this is what I do on marine vinyl. Marine vinyl's thicker, and I don't want my stitches to sink into this vinyl, and these stitches are super dense. So here's what I do. If stitches are really, really dense, whether it's marine vinyl or canvas vinyl or fabric, I always put more stabilizer down. Now, if your stitches are dense, do more stabilizer. So this is tearaway. It's just one sheet of tearaway. I'm going to go ahead and flip my hoop over, and I'm just going to go ahead and float another piece of stabilizer, which will help keep those stitches all in the right place. Now, if you don't have good enough stabilizer on things, that's when you're going to see like the outlines don't match up and stuff like that. So if you ever stitched something and your outline didn't match up with your design, it's probably because it moved and didn't have enough stabilizer just to support those stitches. So I'm going to go ahead and do this second set of stabilizer because the stitches are pretty dense. And I'll just tear this off later. It's just going to support the stitches. Now the other thing I do is, because I'm using marine vinyl, if I wasn't using marine vinyl, if I was using like the canvas vinyl, I wouldn't do this next step. I'm only doing it because this is marine vinyl and stitches can sink into this vinyl. It's really soft, thick vinyl, so the stitches can sink in here and then you won't see them as well and your design won't turn out as crisp and pretty. So I'm gonna go ahead and use this water stabilizer on top. This is mainly used for when you're doing like terry cloth or some really fuzzy, like if you're doing the bunny bag and you're using fur, this is when you want to use this the most. You'll put it over the fur so one, the foot of your machine doesn't get caught in the fur, but also the purpose of this is to keep the stitches above the fabric so you see them better. They don't sink in. So I am using this to try help keep the stitches above this marine vinyl and not for them to sink in. And I have the label over by my machine. So as soon as I get over there, I'll show you what I use for my water stabilizer. This is called WSS water stabilizer. So I just go ahead and float this on top and I just hold it as it stitches the design. You can tape it if you want. It's just basically a plastic that goes over. And the reason they call it water stabilizer is you can put some water on it after and it comes off, it dissolves with water. I think it makes your stuff a little sticky, so I don't actually like doing that. I pull it off, but either way, whatever people like. That's why embroidery is fun, because you can do whatever works best for you. But I'm just showing you how I do it. Feel free to do it however you like, but I'm going to show you my way. Thanks.
Okay guys, I am back at my machine. I have my water stabilizer on. I have my machine ready to go. The first step of the design that we're stitching is step five. This is the lettuce. Now, if you have a PE770, I feel for you, it just looks like a blob and you don't know what's coming next. So you gotta look at the design on your computer if you have the software, or you have to watch a stitch, look at a stitch map. I had that as my first machine, so I feel ya. I know what you're going through. It's the number one reason why I upgraded, because I couldn't tell what I was even stitching next, and I hated going to my computer. That's actually why I bought software. I bought Embrilliant software, so I could actually go to my computer and see what was coming next. But anyways, beyond the point, the next step is lettuce. So I went ahead and put green in, and I just wanted to take one quick second to show you the water stabilizer that I use. I'm sure I bought this on Amazon, water soluble stabilizer. That's why it's called WSS. But there it is. That's what I buy. I'm sure I have a link in the bottom when you guys are done with the video if you want to get to the link. But I'm going to go ahead and stitch step 5. It's the lettuce. I have green in, and I'll come back and show you. Okay, guys, there's our first section of lettuce. Now, we're going to be jumping around a lot, and we're going to be switching thread a lot, but there's a reason for it, just so you know. We're going to be interspersing tomato and cheese, but some of them are going to be above layers and some of them are going to be below layers. And I'll show you what I mean by that. This is why, instead of just, we're not going to stitch all the tomato all at once. We're going to do tomato and then we're going to do some cheese and then we're going to go back and do a different lettuce and then we're going to go back and do tomato and then cheese. So we're going to be switching our thread back and forth, but the reason for that is some of the tomato is going to be above certain stitches and some are going to be below certain stitches, so that's why you have to switch it. So bear with me. So step 6, I'm going to make a piece of tomato. So I have red in. I'm going to stitch step 6 and then I'll come back and show you what we're doing next. Okay, guys, we went ahead and did that piece of tomato. Now we're going to go ahead and stitch step 7. Stitch 7 is cheese. So I'm going to do like this yellowy color. You could do more of an orange color, but the shape of the cheese, and I'll show you in a minute, it reminds me more like strings of carrots if you do an orange. So I do yellow all the way. But I'm going to go ahead and stitch step 7. I'm doing it as cheese, and I'll show you what it looks like. Guys, this is what it looks like so far. We have a couple pieces of cheese, and we have a piece of tomato and a little bit of lettuce. Now, the next step, step 8, is going to be to do more lettuce. I'm changing the lettuce color. I'm making it a little darker, so we have a couple colors of lettuce. And I'm going to go ahead and stitch that. Now, it's going to go ahead and stitch against these. And then when you do the next set of tomatoes and cheese, it's going to go above this layer we're stitching now. That's why you have to go back and forth. And you can't just do all the red at once and all the yellow at once, just so you know. So I'm going to go ahead and put this back in, and I'm going to go ahead and stitch step 8. Again, I changed it to a darker green, and I'll come back and show you. Okay, guys, this is what it looks like with that other color lettuce. Okay, so we are going to go ahead and do our next step, which is going to be another set of tomatoes. So I went ahead and changed to red. I'm going to stitch step 9, and I'm going to stitch that red for tomatoes. I'll come back and show you. Okay, there's the other tomatoes. Now I'm going to go ahead and switch to yellow, and I'm going to go ahead and do the cheese. So step 10, I'm going to stitch more cheese. I'll come back and show you what it looks like. Okay, guys, we have all the tomatoes and cheese done. The other thing I was going to say, if you don't want to switch between the red and yellow type of thing, you could go ahead and just make those all tomatoes if you want. You don't need to put cheese on here. I've seen a couple made that were just all tomatoes, and it was super cute. You can go search on the Parker on the Porch Facebook group and type in taco, and you'll see lots of people's examples on what they did with theirs. But I switched between because I like cheese and tomato. So anyways, we're on the next step. It's step 11. Now this is going to be the outline of the front of the taco, so it's supposed to make it look a little more three-dimensional. So I'm going to use this darker yellow. You can choose whatever color you like, but I'm doing yellow. So I'll come back and show you what it looks like. Okay, went ahead and did that line. Now we are moving on to the taco cheeks. So if you don't want a face on this, you can just skip the next few steps. And the way you skip is you can just get in. Let me close my machine. Everybody's machine's going to have like this plus and minus with a needle. That gets you into the controls of your machine. And then on this machine, if you want to skip stitches, you push these. If you want to skip steps, you press the spool. So you could skip the cheeks, and then you could skip the face, and then you could move on to the rest of the bag. I'm going to make the face because I like the face, so I'm going to step back, but I'm just letting you know you don't have to put the face on the taco. You could just have a taco bag. So I'm going to go ahead. I went ahead and switched to pink for the cheeks. I'm going to go ahead and do that. I'll come back and show you.
Okay, guys, there's the cute little cheeks. We're moving on to the face. So step 13 is going to be this cute face. I'm using black. And I will come back and show you what it looks like. Okay, guys, here we are. Here's the front. This is all the details on here. This is what your back currently looks like right here. You can see all the back stitches on here. So what I do at this point, I'm going to take this extra stuff off because all the details are done. You don't need it anymore. You can see that it's pretty easy just to pull off. I just pulled it all off. There's a few little tiny pieces that you can pull off a little more detail, but I got that off. And then I also am pulling this off. Whether you're done and you're not lining this, or if you are lining this, I still just take this extra piece off. I don't want this extra bulk in my bag. It was just to help stitch the design. So I'm taking the one layer of tearaway that I floated off. I'm leaving the other one still. Okay, so I got those two things off. It was really easy to get off. Now, if you are not floating, or if you are not adding liner, you are pretty much done. All we're gonna do is like open our zipper. You'll be opening your zipper to like here, because you're gonna have to turn your bag. So you gotta open your zipper, add whatever you're adding on the side, and then you put the vinyl like sides together and stitch the last step, and then you're just flipping through the zipper and you're done. I'm doing the liner, so if you're not doing the liner, go ahead and just be patient and you can watch the rest, and I'll show you what you do if you're not doing liner. But the next few steps are for the liner. So we got everything on here, all our details. Now we're going to flip our bag over because we're going to put our liner on, and the very first liner that goes on is this bottom liner. Now the way to know where you line your fabric up to is that zipper teeth line, which is right here. I'm going to get a marker so I can write on it for you. Hang on. So you can see it a little better. Sorry. Right here. That's where you want to line your fabric up to. I'm going to bring it up close. That's where your zipper teeth are. So that's where you want to line your fabric up to. So in order to do your fabric, you prep your fabric the same measure, the same way. You're going to measure this down. You're going to need a piece from down here. You're going to need a piece for up here. And then you're going to need a full piece for all your liner. So you need three pieces of liner. So I already prepped my fabric. I'm using woven fabric. I'm going to use this. Now I do this a little different than some people might like to. So I'm going to show you both ways. I completely double my fabric, so I have a full double layer, because you need, if you're using woven fabric, you can see it's all frayed. You need a clean edge, and to get that clean edge, you have to fold over your woven fabric. So there's a couple things you can do. You can take your ruler and you can measure from your zipper, like your zipper teeth down, because that's what you're going to need. It's right at 3, so you're going to need a little bit more. You can't just do right at 3, you won't make it work. But I would do a double. I would probably go 3 1/4 and I would completely double it. And that's where I cut my fabric. And then I would fold it over. And now I have a clean edge and I place it like right here with tape. I'm underneath my hoop right now. And I do that for the bottom. I do the same thing for the top. I get a full measurement. I double it, iron it in half so I get a clean edge. And then you're going to put the fabric up like this. And then you need a piece of fabric that goes all the way across this. But this one that goes across is the back one. It doesn't need a clean edge because it's going into the bag. So I just need one piece not folded. So I just measure the whole thing not folded. And I iron it. So I have my three pieces of fabric here. Now, if you didn't want to use this much fabric, say it was a really pretty special fabric and you didn't want to waste any, you don't need this thickness, especially with vinyl. You don't have to have it. You could just take the very edge and fold it down like that and iron it and get that edge right there. That all you really need is the edge. I just fold it in half because it's just easier for me. But then you could match up that edge on the side, and then you're not using as much fabric. Okay, both ways, completely fine. So we have our fabric prepped. We are ready to go back to the machine, and I will show you how you add these three pieces. So I will see you over there.
Okay, I forgot to show you. So I lined up my bottom fabric next to that line right there. I have my nice creased folded edge right there, and I taped it down. I'm on the underneath of my hoop. This is underneath your hoop. So I went ahead and did that. This is what's going to stitch first, so you want to tape, and I just used normal Scotch tape to place it down. So now you're going to take this over to your machine, and where it's going to go ahead and stitch this to connect it. So I will meet you at the machine now once you put your fabric
on. Okay, we are back on my machine. I have the fabric on the bottom half of my bag, and we're going to go ahead and stitch the next step. Step 14 is going to stitch that together. So I'll come back and show you what it looks like. And I went ahead and went back to my yellow. I always choose the same color as my bag, because if any of those stitches show, then you're not going to want to see them. So you want the same color. So I went ahead and did that, and I'll show you what it looks like.
Guys, you can see that it stitched it down right there. Now I put the top fabric on. So you go ahead and just place it on the other side of that line and tape it down. And the next step's going to go ahead and attach this to the front. So I will meet you back at the machine and we will stitch the next step.
Okay, here we are. I'm going to go ahead and stitch step 15, which is going to go ahead and stitch that top. So I will come back and show you what it looks like. Okay, guys, here's our front right now. Here's our back. We have all of it down. Now it's time to put the front, the back of your bag on the front. So we're going to be closing this. So it's going to be like this, right sides together. Now, whenever you do this step on any bag, when you're ready to put the right sides together on the front of your hoop, you need to open your zipper. If you do not open your zipper, your bag will not open. So it's a very important step. And believe me, I've forgotten. But you want to pull it open as far as you can get it without going over the stitch lines right here. Now remember, the stitch lines on this side are right here. You need to leave enough room right here so the foot of your machine can get by this and not hit it. If it hits it, it's going to mess up your whole bag. So make sure you have enough room for it to get by, but open as far as you can because you got to flip through this hole. So you want it as big as you can make it. Otherwise, it's going to be a hard time getting the bag through the hole. Okay, so whenever I'm putting the front of the bag on, or the back of the bag on the front, it's going to enclose this whole thing. That's why you need the zipper open. So first step, open your zipper. Second step, this is where you add anything that you want to add to the bag that's going to be hanging off of the bag. So a lot of people can do like straps, so it's like a taco purse, or a lot of people add these little swivel clips so they can hook onto bags or whatever you want to do. I'm going to add a swivel clip. The point is, whatever you're adding right now, you need to add it before your next step. So I have a little bit of fold over elastic. It's just pretty elastic. I'm going to go ahead and take my swivel clip, put it in like this. And then you place it on the inside of your bag because everything else is going to get cut off. So we place this on the inside, and then when you flip, it's going to be like this on the outside. So whatever, you can place it anywhere you want because it's going to stitch all the way around the stitch line. So anywhere you want to put this, or as many as you want to put here, go for it. I'm going to place this one like right here, and I'm taking some tape and I'm just taping it down. Now you can tape both sides if you want. You could tape this down too if you like, but I'm okay with it like that. And then when it's done stitching, it's gonna hang like this up here on the top like that, okay? So the other thing I'm gonna add just as a little decoration is this cute little cactus. This is fold over elastic too. I just want like a little cactus poking out down here. So I want it to basically look like, I'm gonna get this over. Basically look like this when it's done. It's just going to be a little folded over cactus on the front. So you can look at it what you want it to look like when it's done. And then in order to make it work, you have to put it the other direction on the inside. So I lined it up. And now I'm just going to tape it because that's where I want it to stitch. Okay, so when it stitches over this line, it will fold over and it will just look like a cute little cactus right there. So you gotta line it up from this side, okay? Okay, so that's all I'm adding to my bag, those two things. The zipper's open. Now we're gonna go back to the machine and we're gonna stitch the next step. Make sure your vinyl is over all this whole placement stitch right here. Make sure it covers all of it because that's what it's gonna stitch, okay? So line it up so it fits. That doesn't fit on mine. Line it up so it fits and it covers everything, and then we're going to stitch the next step, and I'll meet you over there.
Okay, guys, I have it all lined up, and remember, right sides together, and then we're going to go ahead and do the next step, which is step 16, and it's going to go ahead and close this bag. So I'll come back and show you what it looks like.
Okay, guys, this is what your bag looks like. This is the top of your hoop, the front of your hoop, so it completely enclosed this vinyl. So you see there's no holes, so there's no way to flip this if you kept your zipper closed. Here's the back of your bag. You can see your zipper is right here. This is where we're going to flip through the second time, but we have to do our other piece of lining. So we only have one piece of lining right now. We're going to do our second piece of lining. So this is the one that's not folded over. It's just a whole sheet. You're going to do like sides together. Now I leave a little bit of fabric down here on both. So see how there's some fabric down here at the bottom? We're going to flip through a hole down here, and then we're going to have to eye glue it. We're going to glue the hole. So you want some fabric left down here. So when I place this fabric, I'm just going to make sure that there's still some fabric down here that we can flip through and flip, fold over and glue. You probably don't need as much as I leave, but I'm leaving that much, okay? So you're gonna right sides together. Remember, right sides together, otherwise your liner is gonna be inside out. There you go, so right sides together. I'm just taping it pretty good. This is underneath your hoop. You just wanna tape enough that it stays this direction, doesn't flip over itself while it's stitching, the machine's moving, because that's not fun. Okay, and then I will meet you back at the machine. I didn't tape any down here because my fabric's past it. I could probably tape like right here. We can do that. Just tape it on the side of my hoop. It's not a big deal as long as you put it on your machine where it's not folded over. Okay. So there we go. This is the underneath of your hoop. You have right sides together. I'm going to meet you back over at the machine. And it's basically going to stitch the same way, but it's leaving a hole right here at the bottom. Okay, so I'll meet you over there and show you what it looks like.
Okay, we are on the machine. I always double check to make sure that the fabric stayed down as I slipped it on my machine, and it did. I'm still using the same yellow. This is step 17. It's basically going to do that stitch several times to keep it down. And I'm going to go ahead and stitch it. This is our last stitch step, so I will show you what it looks like when it's done.
Okay, guys, we are done stitching. So here's what the front of your bag looks like, the front of your hoop, I mean. Here's what the back of your hoop looks like. You can see, I'm going to take this tape off. If you watch my other videos, you know I don't like tape because then I have to pull all this off. But you can see that there is a hole right here. We're gonna flip through that first. So we're gonna take this off our hoop. That's our first step. So let's get it off. Okay, all this tape. And then the next thing I do, I always take the stabilizer off just so it's not in my way. So I'm pulling all the stabilizer off. Okay, and then we're going to cut around the design. Now, it matters a little bit how you cut. I'm probably going to cut this vinyl first because the vinyl doesn't need to be here at all. Let me get my other scissors so I can show you. Okay, the vinyl doesn't need to, we don't need this extra vinyl, and actually will be in the way if you have this. And on this bottom, you don't want to cut. I would just use normal scissors and cut across this, but you don't want to cut all the way across this fabric because you need some of this to flip your bag and to glue it. You don't need all of this, but I'm going to cut this vinyl first. So let me just cut around the bag and then I'll show you how I cut that. Okay, so all the way around this bag doesn't matter. You just cut as close to your stitches as you want without cutting your stitches. So I'm just cutting on the outside of the stitches. I'm leaving a little bit so it doesn't pull and you aren't connected to your vinyl anymore. That would be bad. Okay, so I'm just gonna cut all the way around. Make sure you have some pretty good sharp scissors, thick scissors, because you're cutting through many layers of vinyl, the zipper, you're cutting through the fabric liners. It's quite a bit of layers, so you're going to want good scissors. Okay, so that's all done. That's easy. Cut. Move it out of the way. Okay, now the only thing you need to watch is you need to leave some fabric down here because we're going to flip through it. So you can see the stitches end here and here. So I cut at an angle up to those stitches. So I cut like basically like this. And then I cut the same way like this. We have some vinyl in our way right now, so I'm going to cut that. This is why I was talking about getting this vinyl closer. So I'm going to pull this back, and I'm going to cut this vinyl without cutting this fabric. So I'm pulling this back. I'm just going to get some of this out of here. There's just too much. And you don't want this extra vinyl. I'm just going to make it bulky. Make sure you don't cut your stitched line either. I'm just going to cut it a little bit closer if I can. Yep. Make sure I'm not getting my fabric. All right, that's probably good enough. Now, as far as this goes, now you can cut this excess off. Okay, you don't need this much, so I'm going to cut some of it off. Okay, and you actually only need the liner that's going to flip. We have extra liner here, so you only need the two that make the hole, so you can actually cut this as well, so it's not messing with your gluing or your bag. Okay. Go. So we're all cut and ready to go. So your first step is going to be flipping everything through this hole. Now I have thick vinyl, so it's going to take some pushing to get it through. The other thing is this is just woven fabric, so it might tear here. So you got to be really careful when you're flipping this. So just slow and steady, just kind of flip it and push it through. If it rips a little bit here, don't worry. When we're gluing, we can kind of glue the liner part. This is at the bottom of your bag, so it's not the biggest deal. But just try to go carefully. If this was all fabric, it would go right through and be really easy and quick. But since this is the thickest vinyl, it's gonna take me a little bit, and I'll probably just show you a little bit, but I don't think you wanna watch me flip this. It's gonna take me a tiny bit of time, and it's not gonna be so fun to watch. So I just kinda start squishing things through as gently as I can, and you start getting the bag through. See how I'm partway through? And then I just start pulling and flipping a little bit more. Okay, so that's how you're gonna do it. You're just gonna keep pulling a little bit, and you'll get a little bit more through, and then a little bit more through. Okay, and you don't have to get it like perfect, because you're gonna flip one more time. You're gonna flip through your zipper. Now, if you didn't do the liner, you don't have to do this part. You're just flipping through your zipper, and you don't have to glue either. But then all your stitches are gonna be showing. You see how I'm getting this through? Okay. All right. So it wasn't that bad. So I got it completely flipped. My edges aren't really completely out great yet, but it's not the biggest deal because we're gonna flip it one more time, okay? So it's kind of wonky right now, but all you need to see is that you have this hole. And this hole is at the bottom of your bag, and we are gonna glue it. So I'm gonna get this bottom just a little straighter so I can glue it correctly. Okay. This corner's not like out all the way either. Okay. All right, so we are probably good enough. So what I do, this is why I said leave some fabric at the bottom, because I fold it in on itself. I go like this, and then I take this and fold it over, and I kind of sandwich it together and glue. And then you have this nice clean edge at the bottom. It's glued, and you don't even know it's there. Now, once I have it all set and ready, lined up and ready to glue, I'll show you what glue I use. Sorry, I'm just getting it. I take these little wonder clips. You can use whatever. These are nice because they're like small, but you could use like clothes pins or whatever. You just want to hold it for you while you're gluing, basically. So I kind of set it up and straighten it and get it how I want it first. Now remember, this is at the bottom of your bag, so it's not the hugest deal to be like perfect and exact. Okay, so I'm just gonna put this here. So we kind of have it straight, we kind of have it together. Now I use this glue right here, Fabric Tac Glue. I just bought it on Amazon. I'll have all the links there. It's clear, it's easy to use. It dries really fast, like 2 to 5 minutes. I let it sit, and then I'm already ready to finish the bag, flip it again. Okay, so once I have this set, I just open this up a little bit at a time, and then I just put the glue in there. And you gotta, it takes a second to come down. There it is. Okay, so then it's clear. You just put some glue here and then I just smush it back together. If there's any excess, like see I get too much there, I just take some of my fabric that I cut off and I just wipe it. And then I clip it down so it can dry right there. I'm just gonna move this clip over here. And then I go to the next section and I just put a little more, it gets goppy, like all gloppy, sorry, gloppy. So I just wipe some of it off. And then I go right there and I go ahead and put it together and just scoot this over. And that's it, that's all there is to it. Get that off. Okay. We are done with the gluing. Now I'm gonna wait 3 to 5 minutes and then I will come back and show you what we're doing next. But it is completely glued and it just needs to dry a few minutes and I'll come back and show you. Okay guys, we are dry enough and ready to go. So I'm just gonna take these clips off. You can see there's the bottom. That's what it's gonna look like. Now we are gonna be flipping through the zipper. You can see when I flipped the first time it already kind of tore open. Now this is why you need your zipper open, because you wouldn't have this opening if you didn't have your zipper open. Now what I kind of do right now is I take out the stabilizer. There's stabilizer right here in between your fabric and your vinyl. I pull it out now to get it clean. So I'm just gonna clean up my bag a little bit. I'm just gonna pull. A thing that kind of works well when you're doing this is tweezers too. You use tweezers to get this out a little better than my fingers, a little better job. But I'm just gonna get some of it out. And there's gonna be some up here on the top as well. So go ahead and get. Now the top one has the string too. This was a placement stitch. You wanna pull this and it's gonna feel like you're breaking your bag because it's really tight, see? But you're not, you can pull this out. It's just a placement line. This was your center zipper placement line that you want to take out. Okay, and I'm just gonna get the rest of this stabilizer out. Okay. A few more, sorry. This takes a little bit of time. Okay, that's probably good enough. You can do more if you want later. But now we're gonna flip through this hole as well. And it's, the flipping's the same. I'm actually gonna cut this little string right here so it's not in there. Okay. Now we're gonna flip, so I'm just gonna push this through. This one's kind of easy to push through because it's just very little space at the top. Now I'm gonna push the bottom part through. And I normally try to take the corners first and just push them through slowly. You also, this vinyl kind of sticks together too, so it's gonna take a little bit of pushing. So I'm just putting my thumbs in there and then I'm pushing through with my fingers. And just pulling on it so it's starting to come through. This vinyl kind of sticks together, so it takes a little bit. Okay, I'll pull my little thing through. The other thing I use once I get it partially through, I use like a dowel. This was like a turning system. I use the non-pointy edge for the most part. If you push too hard with the pointy edge, you can go through your vinyl and the stitches and your fabric, but These kind of tools could help you too, or the end of a pencil, like the eraser side, would help too. So I'm just gonna try to get these corners out a little bit better, because they're kind of folded in on each other. There we go, we got that corner out a little better. Just kind of push it around and then just kind of mold it with your hands to get the right shape you're looking for. Okay, we're pretty good enough to be able to show you. You can use a little bit more, so I'm going to just zipper it. So your zipper is there. Okay, so here's your taco. Here's your little key fob thing that you can click onto bag so it can hang. This is that cute little detail that I just put at the bottom of the bag. I'm going to put this corner out a little more so it looks a little better, but there you are. You have a lined, fully lined taco bag. So if you open the zipper, you can see that you don't see any of the stitches. You don't see anything. It's completely lined. Really super cute. Really super easy. You just need to follow the steps and it's really easy. This one's a little time consuming because there's lots of different colors. The other thing I'm gonna do, you can see that there's some, if you have like jump stitches, I have some jump stitches here in the cheese and stuff. I'm gonna go ahead and pull those and cut them. I usually use my little snip scissors, but I don't see them, so I'm just going to use my embroidery scissors. So I'm just going to hold that up and cut it so it's not there. So you can just clean up your bag a little bit, and you are done. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Like I said, if you're wanting to know where I get my vinyl, or I have tons of links below. So if you go to see more, you can see all my links. Also, if you like my nails, I sell Color Street. These are Color Street. They're really cute. And I have my links for that as well. Please join my Facebook group. I'd love for you to join me. And otherwise, I hope you love this tutorial. Thank you so much. See you in the next one.